Dignitate, observabris, Domine, Domine, qui sustenebit. Et profundis clamavi a te, Domine, Domine, sare razione in voce meam. Che andare studente, detes in voce interpretazione smei. Si dignitate, observabris, Domine, Domine, qui sustenebit. Via putte propiziatio est, profe legendum sustinuite, Domine. Sustinuit anima mea, verbo eo, speravit anima mea, in Deo, Domino. Custoria matutina usper noctum, sperit Israel in Domino. Quia fu Dominum misericordia, copiosa apuream redemptio, ed ipse redemit Israel et sanctus iniquitatibus eius. Requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et dux perpetua luceat eis.
Si iniquitatis observabris Domine, Domine quis sustinebit.
Angelii. Itai Deus Eos, qui dormierunt per Jesum abducet cum eo. O genim vobis dicimus in verbo Domini, qui a nos qui vivimus, qui residuis sumus in adventum Domini, non preveniemus eos qui dormierunt. Quoniam ipse Dominus in Iusu, et in voce Archangeli, et in tuba Dei descendit de celo, et mortui qui in Christo sunt, resurgent primi. Deinde nos qui vivimus, qui relinquiminur, simul rapiemur cum illis in nubibus obviam Christo in aera, et sic semper cum Domino erimus, itaque consolamini in vicem in verbis isti.
Oh.
caeter et requiem capiat sempre eterne. Perdon nostrum Iesum Christum, filium tuum, tecum viva creatur et ad Spiritus Sancti Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum.
On behalf of Jeffrey Petrino's family, especially his dear and beloved wife Mary, his sisters Marianne Petrino Sheehan and Helene Zalewski, and his brother Philip Petrino, thank you all for coming and praying this morning. I also want to welcome Father Sanderfoot, who was served as the priest for this Requiem Mass, Father Brigida served as the deacon, Father Noah as the subdeacon. Also, Mr. Lally, our MC, and our servers that helped us to worship so beautifully and well. I also welcome Father Fisher, who's the dean of our region, as well as chaplain to the Order of Malta, Father Bjorn Lundberg, and Father McCormick. I do need to clear up one very important matter. We are not going to bury Jeff Petrino today. Of course, Jeff is alive, as our faith reminds us. And as our gospel teaches, Jesus declares to Martha, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, even if he die, shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." Today we give reverent honor to the body of Jeffrey Petrino as a temple of the soul. But Jeff's soul is with God. We'll be burying his remains, but Jeffrey is not there. His life has changed, but not ended, and nor are we to grieve as the pagans do. We naturally feel sorrow at being separated from those we love, but in our sadness, our hearts are full of hope of a future joyful reunion. In the words of St. Paul from today's Mass, "We would not have you ignorant concerning those who are asleep, lest you should grieve, even as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, so with him God will bring those also who have fallen asleep through Jesus." A Requiem Mass was just offered for Jeffrey, so called because of the first words of the Roman Rite from the Introit, which is the entrance antiphon, "Requiem aeternum dona eis, Domine, et lux perpetua luceat eis." Eternal rest give unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. Requiem aeternum, eternal rest. The Christian idea of death as a kind of sleep or rest from which Christ will awaken us is spoken of by St. Broglio. Speaking of our Lord, he says, "His power is so great that it is easier for him to raise the dead to life than it is for us to arouse those who are sleeping." This Mass is one that Jeffrey wanted and is a testament to his love of God and the beauty of traditional worship. a Latin Requiem Mass has its own liturgical customs, which convey a deep meaning about the mystery of our passage from this world to the next. The color black may seem to modern sensibilities a shocking liturgical choice for a funeral, but that is precisely the point. It helps us to acknowledge the loss of a beloved husband, brother, uncle, cousin, friend, and the sadness that comes from being separated with those we love. It also reminds us of the suffering that comes from a slow decline, the long goodbye, for the person themselves with its frustrations and limitations that seem to multiply each day, and for the family, in this case, Mary, who face daily challenges in seeking to maintain the normalcy of a life that keeps slipping away. Mary's love and dedication to her husband Jeffrey are a witness to God's love for all of us and the beauty of marriage, in sickness and in health, till death do us part. Thank you, Mary, and be assured of our prayers for you. Black also reminds us to pray for the soul of the faithful departed and to realize that they are in need of our prayers. Jeffrey certainly lived a good and blessed life, a devout follower of Jesus Christ, and served the church, his family, and our nation. For many years, he organized and led the First Friday devotions of the Nocturnal Adoration Society, became a member of the Ancient Order of Hibernians, as well as the Legion of Mary, Society of Patricians, the Sarah Club. He was a fourth-degree member of the Knights of Columbus and served in numerous positions. But the most important role that Jeffrey lived was as a child of God, embracing his vocation as a husband and father. His quiet kindness and pleasant demeanor remind us of Saint Joseph, the hidden saint, who is the patron of a happy death. Jeffrey received the last sacraments, was anointed several times, and received the apostolic pardon more than once. Maybe a record. But what a great grace and source of consolation to us. But he's still in need of our prayers. The six candles around the coffin echo the six candles on the high altar and beautifully symbolize the embrace of Jeffrey by the light, which is Christ. At his baptism, he became immersed into the Paschal mystery, and we recall that today. May we also bear the light of faith each day, confident of our identity, our destiny, steadfast in prayer and good works, storing up a treasure until the day we meet our Lord. This day is one of grief and love, of loss and hope. In the words of St. Augustine, of necessity we must be sorrowful when those whom we love leave us in death, although we know that they have not left us behind forever, but only gone ahead of us. Still, when death seizes our loved ones, our loving hearts are saddened by death itself. Thus the Apostle Paul does not tell us not to grieve, but not to grieve like those who are without hope. Let us grieve, therefore, over the necessity of losing our loved ones in death, but with the hope of being reunited with them. If we are afflicted, we still find consolation. Our weakness weighs us down, but faith bears us up. We sorrow over the human condition, but find our healing in divine promise. As Christ reminds us in our gospel today, he who believes in me, even if he die, shall live. Our hope in eternal life has a deep foundation in the passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, who conquered sin and death, brought into the world by man. His obedience undoes the disobedience of Adam and Eve. His resurrection conquers death, not only for himself, but all those who are baptized into his body and cling to it on earth, the church. At his baptism, Jeff died to a mere earthly hope and clothed himself in the immortality of his Savior. His life became immersed in Christ, joined to his body, and where the head of the body has gone, the members hope to follow. We assist Jeffrey in his journey over the waters of death by our prayers, and will continue to do so, confident in knowing he will benefit from them, since he really is alive. As we prayed in the collect of this Requiem Mass, O God, bid thy holy angels receive him and bear him to our home in paradise, so that since he believed and hoped in thee, he may not undergo the pains of hell, but may possess eternal joys. We pray that he is now already enjoying the company of parents, younger brother Michael, and beloved daughter Julia. May it be a joyful reunion. May he now possess eternal joy. In filial trust, we place the words of the Dies Irae on his lips, as the liturgy does today. With thy favored sheep, O place me, nor among the goats abase me, but to the right hand upraise me. While the wicked are confounded, doomed to flames of woe unbounded, call me with thy saints surrounded. Lo, I kneel with heart submission, see like ashes my contrition. Help me in my last condition. Spare, O God, in mercy spare him. Lord, all pitying, Jesu blessed, grant them thine eternal rest. Amen. While we pray that Jeffrey is already enjoying the light of heaven, but of course no one is perfect, so we show our love for those who have gone before us by imitating the virtues we find in them and by our prayers and sacrifices. Encouraged by the mystery of God and the goodness of Jeffrey's life, let us entrust him to our Heavenly Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Holy Mary, our hope, seat of wisdom, Saint Joseph, pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
eternal restaurant unto them, O Lord. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, although he be dead, shall live. And everyone who liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Nostra Salve.